Hello sustainable growers, this is Jonathan from Melbourne Aquaponics and today we're going to see how to safely handle fish in aquaponics. So if you are growing fish in aquaponics, there may be some times where you need to handle the fish. It may be just to treat your fish if they are sick, you know, if you want to give them a salt bath. I made a special video about that, so have a look at the video how to treat your fish in aquaponics. It may be because you want to check the growth of the fish and you want to know the biomass, so you have to fish your fish to weigh them and sometimes to measure them. So in all those conditions, we're going to fish the fish and we're going to handle them. So the first thing to understand is that when you're going to fish your fish, when you're going to manipulate your fish, it's going to induce a certain stress on your fish. So you want to make sure that your fish are not fed the day before. So the point number one is to not feed your fish the day before. If you know that you're going to handle your fish, if you know that you're going to stress them, don't feed them the day before. You know, when a fish is eating, then it's going to digest. And when it digests, it consumes some energy because, you know, it needs all those, the metabolism of the fish need to absorb the nutrients. And it consumes a lot of oxygen, a lot of energy. So don't feed the fish the day before, otherwise they're going to be in digestion. And when you stress them, they may not recover. So never feed a fish when you know that you're going to stress or when you're going to handle the fish after. The point number two is to use fish-friendly nets. So you know that when you're going to handle your fish first, you have to catch them and most of the time you're going to use a net. So this net has to be fish-friendly. So what I mean by fish-friendly, I mean a net that is not rough because the fish has got scales and mucus. And if you fish the fish with a net that is rough, you know, for example, a classic butterfly net, some of them are very smooth, but some of them are very rough. So if the net is rough, it's going to basically remove some slim from the fish, the mucus of the fish is going to be removed and it's going to stay in the net. And sometimes you can even remove some scales. And obviously the scales and the mucus are barrier against the disease. So if you remove them from the fish is going to become weak. And any disease that is going to arrive, especially fungus and parasites, they're going to find directly the flesh of the fish and it's going to be able to stick on the fish and obviously to start to attack the fish. So your fish become very weak. So avoid those type of nets that are very rough. Choose some nets that are very soft. So here I got a few. I got the classic butterfly net. I got the net that people are using when they go fishing. So this one is in very hard plastic. So if it's hard plastic, it's not the best because it can be it can basically remove the mucus of the fish. And then I got another type here that is more smooth. So this one is really good. It doesn't have to be too elastic. Sometimes they are very elastic and then the fish can put their head through, you know, and then the gills are trapped in the net. So that would be the worst because that's basically killing the fish. So use a net that is soft, such as this one, really good, but not too elastic. If you are catching small fish, use a net with very, very small mesh. You'd never want to use a net where the fish is able to put his head through the hole, right? So in this net, for example, I would never use this net to catch little fingerlings. This net is for fish that are 1 kilo and more, right? But not for small fish. The third point is to have wet hands. So I need to explain you exactly what happens when you touch a fish. A fish is wet, obviously it lives in the water. When you catch it with your net, you put it in a bucket, whatever, and then you're going to catch it with your hands. If your hands are dry, and if you catch the fish directly, the fish that is still wet, what is happening is that you got a force. I don't know if you heard about this word, the capillarity. It's a force that basically the water is going to wet the dry area. So for example, if you take a piece of paper and you put it touching the water, you know, the surface of the water is going to be in contact with the paper, but you're going to see that the water is going to go up through the piece of paper. It's simply the capillarity. And that's the same thing when you touch a fish with your hands. If you got dry hands, the moisture is going to start to go on your hands and it's going to stick to your hands, right? Which is fine, but the problem is the mucus of the fish is going to do the same thing. It's going to stick to your hands, it's going to remain on your hands, and sometimes with fish that have a very soft skin and some scales, If they have very thin scales, the scales may stick to your hands, which means that when you touch the fish, you don't realize, but then when you release the fish, you look at your hands and you got all the scales that are sticked to your hands. And the fish obviously has got a large part of his body without scales, which is again a big source of entrance for the disease. So avoid this. Every time you have to touch a fish, first you touch the water, you wet your hands, and then you can start to touch the fish. A technique that we see very often is people who catch the fish by the gills. You know, they put their hands, their fingers through the gills of the fish and they hold the fish like that. It may seem like a really good idea because obviously the fish is very slimy. It slides through your hands and it's very hard to keep the fish in a good position if you just take it by the body. So some people think, okay, if you put it by the gills, it gives you a really good trap. You know, you grab it really well. And therefore the fish can't go away. The problem when you do that is that the gills of the fish are like our lungs. What is happening in the gills? You got some very small vessels of blood and all the blood of the fish is going through those vessels, and that's where basically the oxygen is able to go through the membrane of those vessels and to go inside the blood of the fish. So you understand that the vessels are very, very small and very fragile. They are very soft, very fragile. And if you put your hands through, you're gonna basically damage those vessels. And obviously when you put the fish back into the water, the fish is gonna bleed from the vessels and it's gonna basically lose all its blood and it's gonna die. So the worst thing to do is to touch the gills. You never wanna touch the gills of the fish. Even in aquaculture, when the water is dirty, sometimes the fish, when they breathe, they get some material that is clogged on the gills and it can damage the gills. It's to tell you how fragile it is. So never touch the gills of a fish with your hands. You're really gonna kill the fish. So the best thing to do is to just grab the fish from underneath, from the body, you know, one hand on the tail and one hand just below the head, under the tummy. So that's a really good grab. If you know that the fish are dead, then you can take them by the gills. That's really the best way because you really maintain them, you really grab them, but never do it on a fish that is alive. And even on a dead fish, just be careful what type of fish it is because some fish, some big predators, they got some kind of teeth. So basically the gills are very sharp. And when you put your hands through, you may basically cut your hands. But that's very specific. Here we are to talk about fish that are alive and we want to keep alive. So never put your hands through the gills of the fish. And the last point, the fifth point, is to watch out for the last move. You know that when you catch a fish at the beginning, the fish is moving very fast, trying to escape. And after a while, he's very quickly exhausted and he doesn't move anymore. That's when normally you have to grab it and you do whatever you have to do if you want to measure the fish, or if you want to weigh the fish, whatever you want to do. If you want to have a look if everything is fine on the fish, whatever you have to do, you do it at this point where the fish is tired. But be careful, because when you take the fish is going to be afraid and most of the time it's going to move. And that's where basically a lot of people are letting the fish slide and fall down on the floor. A fish that falls on the floor can be very, very seriously damaged and can die after, because all the organ internals, they are not designed to absorb any shock. So when the fish fall on the floor, it may looks fine when you put it back in the water, but it may die a few hours after. You know, inside there is a bladder. The bladder is full of air. When the fish fall on the floor, sometimes it just the bladder explodes, and you got all the other organs, such as the liver, the heart, all the intestina. All those organs, they are very, very fragile. So never let a fish fall from a high distance, you know, high height. If you have to grab the fish and to have a look at the fish, stay below, you know, you stay just on top of a bucket of water or whatever, or on top of a mat, but just a few centimeters above. Never grab it at your height. You know, the people who do that is normally to take pictures, right? But when you examine a fish in aquaponics, you don't need to take any specific picture. So just grab the fish. Just if you have to lift it, just lift it a few centimeters, so that if it fall down, it fall down back on the water or down on the mat, but you don't damage the fish. That's the worst thing you could do, is to grab a fish that is just caught. you grab it at your height. If the fish just give a little movement, it's going to slide, it's going to fall down, and you may kill your fish. So that's the 5 points to basically handle your fish in total safety. If you are just started aquaponics, please have a look at the free guide that we offer, the 6-step guide that is into the description just below. You're going to find a link, and I'm going to send you this guide, which is going to basically allow you to build your own aquaponics setup in the best condition. So I'm going to give you the best ratio to respect and the limit of aquaponics. If you like the video, please give it a like. If you are new to this video, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, because I give you tips every week. So if you subscribe, you're going to receive them every week. You're going to receive the new aquaponics tips. And together, we're going to progress and we're going to produce some fantastic food for you and your family. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.
Don't forget to get your free gift from this screen. You can also leave me a comment below the video, subscribe to the channel, and see my last video. I really hope to see you soon, and I wish you a fantastic success with aquaponics. Have a good crop!